Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Daytona International Speedway as we get ready for Daytona 500 qualifying. That's right, finally, everybody who's ready, all 42 drivers on the Season 10 of the Budweiser All-Pro Series is here and ready to make their qualifying laps for the Daytona 500. This is going to be fun to say the least. They've got about 15 minutes. We're going to get ready to go through the field here at Daytona. And we're going to start with the driver who just put a lap down. That's this driver right here, even though technically it's not a lap that counts. This is the number 43 of Alex Miller. He goes from the 44 to the 43. This is a whole new, because this is a whole new mod, there's no customs. So all of these drivers are basically in new places at this time. So Alex Miller making his return to the Budweiser All-Pro Series for the final season. Going around now, we're going to talk about the new driver in the 12. This is Matthew Logan. Rookie Matthew Logan going to make his series debut driving that number 12 for Penske Racing. Well, look at all these other drivers coming out of pit lane right now. Down into the corner here, we're going to keep an eye. We're going to go ahead and go back. Cole Deaver driving the number 8 car this season. Driving the car in honor of Dale Earnhardt Jr. Because we know he's a big Earnhardt fan. Right behind him is another big fan of that number 5 Terry Labonte car. And that's Kyle Matthews making his return to the Budweiser All-Pro Series. Finally on a team that's not related in any way whatsoever with Jess or Charles. So this will be interesting. Here comes David Gum driving that number 6 car, rookie, making his debut in the Budweiser All-Pro Series. The rookies are going to probably try to show up the field this time. Show up the veterans as a lot of rookies made the chase last year. This season, however, there is no chase, so you've got to be consistent to win the championship. Jose Mills driving that number 14 Navy Chevrolet. He's back here. Ought to be good, making his return. Battling with that number 30. That's rookie Jimmy Dawson in that number 30 AOL.com Chevrolet. Boy, is that a throwback. Interesting to see how he does. We have, I forgot to put a rookie next to his name. I'll fix that. Tyler Reed in that number 22 car, Caterpillar Dodge. He's making his debut in the Budweiser All-Pro Series. Driving for Bill Davis Racing, Seth Cole. Driving that number 38, M&M's Ford for Robert Yates Racing. We have a big group of cars here. Daniel Voiles in the 01 U.S. Army Pontiac alongside the 32 of James Qualls up there. We have the 15 of Benny Watson making his Budweiser All-Pro Series debut. Driving for Dale Earnhardt Incorporated right behind him. William Brock makes his return after I think he was in season 8.1, I don't remember. But he was not in season 9, but he makes his return to the Budweiser All-Pro Series for the final season. And then behind him, we have the 17 of rookie Casey Nanako I apologize if I said that wrong. I sounded it out the best I could. We have a big group of cars here that could make a big difference as to who gets the pole. Right behind them, we have the number 10 of Bobby Frazier. I think I've heard of that name before, but I'm not quite familiar. 15 car looks to be coming to pit road. Probably doesn't like the group of the pack that he's in right here. We have the number 88 of rookie Adam Flickinger. I'm assuming that's relation to William Flickinger, who ran his final Budweiser All-Pro Series race last night in the Budweiser Shootout. Robert Yates' racing teammate to Seth Cole is Adam Flickinger. Oops, wrong button. Now we're back here to a three-wide battle. We got Jack Halleck, who drove the 22 car last season Two wins in his rookie season and a chase and almost a final four spot, but the final eight, just he couldn't quite get it done. Jack Halleck now driving the four Kodak Pontiac. Sky Commons makes his return after a long time in the Budweiser All-Pro Series, driving that number 31 singular wireless Chevrolet for Richard Childress Racing. Phil Parker making his return to the Budweiser All-Pro Series, moving to the number 40, the number 40 Coors Light Dodge out of Chip Ganassi Racing. And then we have another group of cars back here. Ryan Acosta making his Budweiser All-Pro Series debut, driving that number 60 Haas Automation Chevrolet out of Haas Racing. That's kind of a satellite team, if you will, to Hendrick Motorsports. So they get some of their parts and stuff from Hendrick Motorsports. Kev Shearer driving the Carrot Top Call AT&T Dodge out of BAM Racing, making his return, third time in the series. Sebastian Kukulon making his return to the Budweiser All-Pro Series, driving that number 42 Texaco Haviland Dodge out of Chip Ganassi. He's looking forward to his return. Johnny Gardner making his return as well. We saw him in the Budweiser Shootout. Almost got the win in that number 7 series Dodge. I forgot exactly what team that was from. I'll have to look it up when I go back through the cars. Carter Friesen, rookie, making his debut, driving the Kevin LePage number 57 CLR Racing Ford. As you see a couple of cars making their way to pit road. Talked about the 15 already. Here comes the 18, Cole Baker, who, again, I forgot to put the rookie next to his name, or the R symbol next to his name, but Cole Baker is a rookie in the Budweiser All-Pro Series. So, to keep an eye on that rookie, he could very well take some wins away from a lot of these drivers. Rookie Caleb Kilburn in the 41 car. Probably one of the actual rookies who would get rookie stripes in this series. Caleb making his debut, driving the 41 Target Dodge for Chip Ganassi. Ooh, here's a big pack here. We've got Levi McIntyre, driving number 99 Sitco Ford for Roush Fenway Racing. Up here, we've got the 33 car of Benjamin Miles. Benjamin Miles is making his return, driving that number 33 satellite team for Richard Childress Racing. Zachary Fitzwater making his return. I know I've had Zach Fitzwater in my series before. Driving that number 29 GM Goodwrench Chevrolet from Richard Childress Racing. Zach Rogers driving the 97 Rubbermaid Sharpie Ford from Jack Roush. He's looking to continue on with the success he had in the last season. Oops, wrong button. Carson Gumm makes his return to the Budweiser All-Pro Series, driving that number 19 UAW Dodge. Dodge Dealers UAW Dodge, number 19 out of Ray Everham. Jordan Lopez makes the switch from, well, he's still in a Ford. He goes from the 17 to the 16, here in the Budweiser All-Pro Series. We've talked about Cole Deaver already. Dylan Young driving that number two Miller Lite Dodge from Penske Racing. Looking to break the curse that was his last season. Hoping to get to have a better season this time around. Cody Lamas in that number 48 car, making his return. J.J. Roberts moves over to the one for DEI. Corey Williams makes his debut in the Budweiser All-Pro Series, driving that number 23 Stacker 2 Dodge. It seems like we've covered just about everybody, except for we got Jonathan Zorlein driving the 25. Rookie Derek Hamill, I'm not sure exactly how to say it. Seth will correct me once again. He's in the 21 car making his debut. Here's Jay Jefferson driving that number 20. Jay Jefferson driving the 20 car. There's one particular person I have not seen, and I'm quite surprised that we haven't seen her. Here we go. The number 9 of Jessica Shelton in this pack here, driving for Ray Evernham, her all-time favorite NASCAR driver, Bill Elliott, hoping to do him proud, driving this number 9 Dodge. And I think that's everybody. I believe I've covered everybody now, yep. So let's go ahead and keep an eye on the front row, which currently consists of the driver leading this pack right here, Matthew Logan. I mean, they don't call him the Rocket Man for nothing. So something seems to be amiss on that 12 car. He's running about 190, and he's probably just letting these cars go by. He's got nothing really to lose. Keeping an eye on Matthew Logan. Cole Deaver is also second on the list. He's the only positions locked up in this qualifying session are first and second. If that's it, everybody else will get determined in the duels. But right now, only first and second place will be locked up in this qualifying session. Keeping an eye out, we have a driver that just jumped into the third position. If I can find that person, there he is right here. The 60 of Ryan Acosta just jumped up to third. They're in a three-wide battle here. These drivers keeping up. Cole Deaver is in this pack. If he could just somehow find a way to gain a little bit of time. Oh, there's another person I don't think we talked about. Driving to zero, Daniel Price. Rookie Daniel Price. Making his debut in the Budweiser All-Pro Series. Keeping an eye on this three wide situation here. Doesn't look like we're going to see anybody actually retire out of the race or out of practice, which is good, which means nobody's going to have to go to a backup car. Let's go back and find this 12. Well, he's coming to pit lane. The 12 car has officially called it quits, I believe, for the rest of this practice session, or qualifying session, excuse me. So the 12 of Ryan Newman hits his pit stall, and he is completely done from this race. That's not going to a backup car. He's just basically NR's version of putting it behind the wall So he is done. The session is over. We have about 45 seconds of to allow these drivers possibly to complete the lap that they are on. After that, the laps will not count. If you do not complete your lap by the end of this lap counter, you are done. Keep an eye on this pack here. This pack approaching 196 miles per hour. We're going to see if any of these cars can get any last-ditch efforts. We've seen it happen before. Coming to the line this time, the last 10 seconds. 45.095 for Kev Shear. That moves him up to 21st. And now the session is done, and we had a jump to the top of the board. I told you it was possible. The 43 of Alex Miller and the 21... Oops. And the 21 of Derek Hamill, sorry, I'm going to probably mess that up a lot. I apologize. Have jumped up to the top of the board. And here we go. I told you it was going to happen. Alex Miller, Derek Hamill, and Sky Commons. And Will Benny Watson, even though he didn't exactly get faster than the 12 car. But Alex Miller and Derek Hamill, god damn it, sorry. They have jumped up to the top of the board and they have claimed the pole and the second place starting spot for the Daytona 500. This will be the 43 car's first pole in the Daytona 500 in the history of the Budweiser All-Pro Series. I said that totally backwards, but, you know, I'm dyslexic, so not really, but still. So the 43 car, Richard Petty's old number, is going to be the first time that he will start on the pole in the Budweiser All-Pro Series. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you guys for the dual races coming up later on in the week. For Michael Norman, actually, I'm going to go ahead and scroll down here because I forgot. Here you go. There's the last half of the grid. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day or night, depending on whenever this goes up. And we'll see you guys for the Gatorade Duels. This qualifying session has been a production of the NNSCRA Offline Racing and its best saying, until we meet again.